It's my first time doing a live video, so I think it's broadcasting. It says live in the upper left corner, so we'll see how this works. But this is my experiment for the next, let's do 30 days. We'll do 30 days of FAQs. But I get a lot of questions from a lot of people about tech and startups and UX research and all the things I do. Coaching. What is coaching like? I did an exercise in one of groups I belong to. I went to Wellesley. Our alum network is amazing. So if you are a Wellesley alum watching this video, shout out. So today I'm going to answer the question I get possibly the most often, which is how I got into UX research. So hi, Deep Tea. Thank you for coming. Oh, it's nice. Some people are watching. This is all very new to me. So how did I get into UX research? So I went to college. I went to Wellesley College, which is this small elite liberal arts college in the Northeast. Essentially, I am the ivory tower. Wellesley is all women. It's where Hillary Clinton went. It's where Madeleine Albright went. We have a lot of very illustrious alums, but it's a liberal arts school. So I went to college and I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life. I did have friends in various disciplines. I was friends with a lot of college students in high school, so I essentially took courses based on what they liked. And first semester, I took a computer science course, and as it turns out, I was really good at it. And so I continued with computer science because, like, I'm really good at this. I bet I can make a bunch of money doing this, which is true. But at heart, I've always been a social scientist. In high school, I was always really interested in people and understanding people in systems. So I took a lot of social science courses. I ended up in political science, which I absolutely adored. And that became my passion. I in fact thought I was going to go to graduate school and get a PhD in political science. So I did a lot of research. For example, I had an internship at Harvard in their Nuclear Policy Institute, which was incredible and such a boon to my resume. My summers, I did an REU, which was actually computer software focused. So I graduated in 2008. And I had no idea what I was gonna do after I decided not to get a PhD in political science. And I realized I could combine my technical skills and my sort of social science people related skills. And I got a job in management consulting. In fact, my senior year, I interviewed probably with 50 companies. I got multiple job offers. I decided to be a management consultant. Turns out I hated it. I hated all the travel. I hated all the pressure. So I quickly moved to a job right in the middle of the economic crisis. I got a job at EMC where I was a business consultant. Essentially what I was doing was UX. I didn't know it was called UX. I had never heard of UX. In fact, I didn't hear of UX for a few years. So I was doing things like user testing and gathering requirements and working with stakeholders, essentially all the stuff you do in UX. At some point, my partner at the time, who eventually was my husband and then ex-husband, but he was involved, he was in information science school and told me about HCI. So I started learning about HCI and psychology and cognitive science alongside him, and we would have lots of conversations about it. And at some point I realized, you know what, I really, really want to build systems for people. I really care about building systems for people. And I actually had an interest in the environment, so I figured, can I design environmental systems? Can I design ecosystems? So I took I also started taking courses in graduate, you know, biology and ecology and things along those lines at Harvard. And I realized that I, once again, still had no idea what I wanted to do. I thought that landscape architecture might be a good fit, but as it turns out, it's apparently mostly designing gardens for rich people. So this was what, 2011, 2012, somewhere in that range. And I decided that, you know, maybe I should look more into this HCI stuff, this, you know, designing systems for humans, because I know how to, like, test stuff. I know a lot about people. I know about research methods because, you know, I thought I was going to get a poli sci degree. So I got a research assistantship at a government R&D company, essentially doing HCI work, which was incredible. And suddenly I knew what UX was. UX was a term that is less, at least at the time, was less common in the East Coast. So, so I learned what UX was, and I realized that I needed to go to grad school. I needed to learn more about methods. I needed to learn more about how to study people. So I went to a graduate program in environmental conservation at UMass Amherst. And originally I thought I was gonna focus on geospatial stuff because that was a very technologically oriented side of environmental conservation. I knew a lot about GIS. I took some GIS courses at Harvard. So I assumed I was somehow going to design technology with maps. Turns out I actually just really wanted to be even more of a social scientist, and I ended up taking a lot of courses in anthropology and sociology and things along those lines. This is when I really got hardcore about learning how to be really good at user interviews and learned about ethnography, and I did all these cool projects out in the world with people building experiences for them. So my master's thesis ended up being a case study of a invasive plant species reporting app. And essentially I did ethnography with a bunch of students on it, and it was fabulous, and my thesis was amazing. And it's still amazing and readable if you really want to read like 90 pages of stuff about essentially expertise and jargon and how it serves to like exclude people. It's a really good thesis, I promise. During grad school, I had realized I had sort of found my path that like studying people and using my skills in social science and a little bit in computer science was my passion. So I actually started consulting for startups. I started my own business. Eventually ended up out on the West Coast. Essentially, when I was done with graduate school, I moved out with my partner, my husband at the time. We were both in the tech industry. So then I just started working with startups. I had my own consulting business. I focused on a bunch of different stuff, really anything in the UX realm. I had a couple of people working for me. We even did some front-end development. So I was much more of a generalist at that point. At some point I realized I didn't like the overhead and stuff of running a consulting business, like getting pitches and doing a lot of the paperwork and a lot of the things that are the less fun part of owning a business. I realized at that point I didn't want to deal with it, so I was going to go get a job at a real company. Not that my company wasn't a real company, but a big company, one that was established. Even though I was pretty successful with clients, I just wanted experience working from some other people in UX. So I remember at the time looking at my resume and being unsure what kind of jobs I could apply for because I had a very broad background. I had, you know, a lot of experience in social science research. I had a lot of experience. I had experience in tech and more on the technical side. I could still program. I could really have done anything in marketing. I sort of had the generalist resume for a while, but then I decided that it wasn't serving me. I was applying for jobs and people essentially kept asking me questions about like, what do you really do? What do you really care about? Because I was a generalist, and generalists, for whatever reason, have a harder time getting jobs. So at some point I had to do a reckoning with myself and be like, all right, I have all these skills, but what do companies really want? And also, what do I really want to do? And the part that I loved the most was interacting with people and then making recommendations based on my interactions with people. So I marketed myself as a UX researcher. I officially became a UX researcher, even though I'd been doing UX research probably for 5+ years at that point in one form or another. Then I got a job at Salesforce, where I worked for a couple years on brand new products on health cloud and financial services cloud, also retail, which was a new product at the time. Salesforce also has a survey product now. I was involved in bringing that to market and like growing that up. So I did a lot of really cool stuff there that was very impactful. And then, you know, then I moved on to another startup and here I am today. I mean, I have a very broad set of knowledge that comes up in random circumstances. I mean, I actually have a pretty strong graduate level education in ecology and ecology research, which I never use. same with the mapping stuff, the GIS stuff. I don't use that as much as I would love. Political science. I also have a strong political science background. I garden. I do all sorts of things. So I actually think my very broad, diverse background and curiosity about a lot of things is one of the reasons I got to where I am today. I'm trying to think of what else is helpful or illustrative in terms of my journey. I think I always was asking questions. I was always questioning the right way to do something, in particular, not accepting things as they are. So a lot of the stuff that's now sort of taken for granted in design and UX research back in the day either didn't exist or wasn't published or wasn't shared. So a lot of what I did was really around thinking, like, if I were to be pragmatic about this, what is the best way to do this? And not just like accepting things the way they are. So I think that's really benefited me. And really being honest about what I love and what I'm good at. I could have taken a very different path and become a software engineer, but I really didn't enjoy programming all that much. For me, programming was always a means to an end rather than an end itself. If any tool, technology was always a tool for me. So that's why I'm on the UX side of things rather than the more technical side of things. But my computer science knowledge does come in handy. I can have conversations with pretty much anyone in the company and know what they're talking about. I still am able to geek out about algorithms and stuff, even though I kind of don't care because I care about solving problems for people. And yeah. So that's how my career in UX research unfolded. I'd be curious if people have any more questions based on that somewhat long-winded explanation, but yeah, comment in the thingy and I will answer any questions you have. Thanks, guys. It's my first live.